went over to Tom Stamey's house, and he quickly produced the replacement bolt spring, bolt and trigger spring. We're going to give it a good cleaning and fresh oil and reassemble. So we're going to start out with some sweet shooters, run it down the bore and the cylinder, make sure that they're protected. I think we figured out that this gun was made in 1897, I believe, or 1887. And so let you see with the modern plastic pipe what the inside of a over 100 year gun looks like. So then, let's do the same thing. Just to let you see this, well, you can see it there, but those are all nice and clean also. So, I'm going to shut off the sharpshooter there. Sweet shooter, Tecrolon sweet shooter. Almost wouldn't know that the gun's been shot. Now, if you notice, here's our bushing, cylinder bushing, and we're going to clean up here in this hole in the cylinder, just make sure it's clean and free of debris. Looks like it's nice and clean. We're going to give it a little tap. Okay. Okay. And then we'll, looks like at one point in time it was probably fired with some black powder and it wasn't cleaned probably totally properly. You can see just a little bit of, I'm not going to say rust, but where it got pitted probably from being shot with black powder. Though quite honestly, that's pretty minor damage. Okay. Even a 100-year-old gun, it doesn't hurt to protect the metal. And this sweet shooter, from what I've seen, it protects the bluing. Was just a touch, a couple of sprinkles of rust there. That should take care of that. This is our ejector housing screw. Get it cleaned up. And then the ejector. Okay. I'm going to put the sweet shooter here where the ejector housing goes, and then that way we'll put some corrosion X on there also after we let that sit for a little while, but that way if I don't get back to cleaning this for a few years, it will be protected in the absence of any further cleaning. this is your ejector spring, or ejecting rod spring, I guess you call it. And the screw that holds the spring and the pin that engages the loading gate and holds it in position. All right, you put it on the floor there, and there is a foam mat down there so that when I get clumsy fingered like that, then things don't get damaged. So that would be something that I would suggest in the area that you work on your valuables. It's a good thought to have a foam mat underneath you so that if something makes its way to the floor, that it is protected from any unnecessary damage. Hard to say, that spring may have been the first time it's been out since the gun was built. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do, Crojan X, I have two different flavors of it. I just really have had good luck with this. This is a 6-ounce can, aerosol, tends to waste the product. That at Alpine sells for $9, and that's probably about a year old, maybe 2 years old. This picked up at Elk Castle over in Fort Worth, which is also Crojan X, but it is in a bottle form, and this one is many years older, and it was a whole $7. Quite honestly, you get more mileage out of this one. But again, Crojan X, if you noticed in my other video that I did on guns, is my favorite for protecting against rust, just overall maintenance and cleaning and lubrication. Seems to do a nice job. It's even nicer when you find something that does a nice job and doesn't cost an arm and leg. So we're gonna get that lubricated up. Down a clean spot here. Give her a screw and the pin, and especially the spring. Those should be ready to go back in, down in that. And then also we're going to put a drop over here in the loading gate. Go ahead and put a drop in our screw holes here just for we don't have to mess with it again as we put it back together. I'm going to go ahead and lubricate the inside of that also while I've got it, and then that way this can all be noticed earlier there was a start, and it must be several years old, but just an itty bitty bit of rust right there, which is may have come from when it was in a holster. Put the ejector gate back in. Okay, so the first thing would be the pin, followed by the spring. Followed by the screw. So we're going to go ahead and put a little bit of Crojan X, and that will give us a good put us in a good position to when we put this back together, everything will have a nice little coating of Crojan X so that okay, so we have Crojan X now on our ejector rod. And so we should be ready to reassemble that to the gun. So first off, put one drop, just get the spring something to ride on. Spin it around a little bit to circulate that. The way this ejector rod goes in is it goes into that notch right there, turns, then goes in the rest of the way, and then, excuse me, it would help if we put that in the right hole, and that lines up with the barrel mounting lug. Corrosion X that we put in there, we're going to just finger tighten this initially. No sense in worrying about getting it super tight at this point in time. Now then, we have our ejector rod installed. Gun screwdriver kit that I bought back when I graduated from college. It served me well over the years, but you typically want to make sure that the bit that you're using fills the slot, and this one, this particular gun set comes with also for each width, there's also a breadth of the blade itself. So if you can get the one that fits the screw head and then fills the slot, you minimize the chances of slipping out and are damaging the screw. As you can. So we're going to make sure the hammer is clean. Okay, so the hammer is nice and clean. And we have our hand, moves the cylinder and brings the next chambered round to the firing position. I bet you that's another spring there that could let go, and that would cause you a problem. This screw should remove last, trigger screw second, and then the bolt screw first. And then so it would make sense that when you go back together that you would want to reverse that order, which we will do today. Okay. Okay, so the hand goes in the hole this way on the trigger with the spring backwards. And then we want to make sure our bolt is ready to go. We will so you want to verify that the hand is doing its job, and the hand is doing its job. I hate to say it, but it's almost working too good. And I know you experienced people out there. First off, the experienced people probably aren't watching this video. But there are other ways to put this together, folks. It just doesn't work as well. So, like I said, it doesn't hurt to learn something new. So we're going to make sure the trigger is clean. This is a friction point for the trigger. And we're going to put just a little bit of tetra lube there. Just to, we're going to go ahead here and get a little spring. Again, this was the culprit. I think I threw the other one away because it's not here on the table. But was the culprit. We will prevent any further damage. So with that, put one drop of oil in there. And now then, trigger goes in. And if you remember, this is where our whole problem started, was with the spring that puts pressure on this bolt. So, okay, so the bolt is going to fit in this hole, so it can go up through the frame and lock. Trigger goes over to the that side of the frame. And then the bolt drops in like that. And then our freshly cleaned and lubricated screw then goes into the hole in the bolt as such. Hope you can see that. Okay, so with that, we're going to do our final tighten. Okay, so we're back to the point at which this all started. And put some Crozinex on our spring here. And for such a troublemaker, it goes back in really easy. There we go. It's really not a troublemaker, it's just apparently a part that's prone to breaking. And a single action army. It's good. What we're doing is just checking the timing, and right now the bolt is retracting, and it's retracting nice and flush, so we should not get a cylinder ring. So it looks like we were successful. Ooh, nice smooth fit. Okay, so that's ready. Go ahead and get that ready for reassembly. Then I will need to tighten that up, but that works fine now. That one there. That one there. Okay. I think that is all we really need. Okay, feels good. So now we've got our cylinder pin spring put back in. Okay. We're going to make sure the groove on the spring is on the roller. Make sure the trigger passes through, and then we'll put the second screw in. One more again to make sure we're staying in the slot here. Okay, and then we put the front screw back in. Feels good. Okay, so now then we want to make sure that one's just a little bit different on the okay. That one has a narrower slot in it for whatever reason than these back two, which is okay. Just use the right screwdriver to prevent. So I don't know that there's a perfect way to do this one, other than the fact that do that finger tight. That one started. Okay. Get a good grip on the firearm so it doesn't slip out of your control. Been really successful so far without putting any nicks on the screws or scratches, so it'd be nice to keep it that way. So we're going to wipe off any excess oil from the grip area. This grip goes on that way. That grip goes on that way. Okay. Okay, so if I remember correctly, you want to pull back the second notch, open the loading gate, carefully drop the cylinder in, rotate it just a hair to the right, close the loading gate, insert our pin, and then we line it up into the first notch. So here we go to see. Oh my gosh, perfect. Lock up and, oh, trigger is better than it used to be. So, I hope you enjoyed the video that we shot here today on replacing the bolt and trigger spring. Hope I haven't bored you. And single action army, single, made in 1887, original, all matching, with a new bolt spring supplied by Tom Stamey, close friend of mine. So thank you for watching, and check out my other videos on YouTube.